buying this argument that Dr. Anant is giving us, that it is because of WPI going into negative in the year ago period and now being positive that you are seeing the real GDP lower this time because you have a higher deflator compared to last year. The reason why I am not able to buy this argument is, if you look at the nominal GDP, where there should be no impact of deflator at all, it is still the lowest GDP number for the past 5 quarters. I mean, I can read out for the last 8 quarters, 8.7, 6.6, 8.3, 10.4, 8.7, 9.4, 9.4, 11.3. So at 5.7, this is still the lowest. You can go through all cycles of WPI. This is still, in real terms, only a 7.9% growth. The lowest growth for the last 6 quarters, actually. Is this really a WPI effect?
You know, just talking about the total WPI simply doesn't make sense, because WPI is used both for the output as well as for the inputs while calculating GVA. Now, the real issue out here is that have you actually broken it up by an output deflator and an input deflator? That could create a problem. At the moment, we're doing pure single deflation. Mm. So you're using the same WPI number for inputs and outputs. Mm. Right? Mm. So there can be a compositional effect. Mm. But to simply say that because the WPI was negative, you had an abnormal bump up in the GVA estimate. Mm. Now that has gone into the positive territory, it's giving abnormal downside to the GVA. I don't think quite washes. Okay.